properties of random variable x and its density function. If x is a discrete random variable with the range space and the probability density function f of x or p of x equal to x, then it has two properties. First one is non-negativity. Second one is sum of the probabilities equal to 1. First one non-negativity, second one is sum of the probability equal to 1. So non-negativity means that a value p of x equal to x, we are indicating the x equal to xi sometimes, okay, which is equal to real value pi probability. That value is always greater than or equal to 0. And summation x belongs to Rx range space. We are taking each x from the range space. P of x equal to x, which is equal to summation I pi. I am taking the real values, which is exactly equal to the 1. Sum of the all probabilities are equal to 1 in discrete case. If x is a continuous random variable and its probability density function is small f of x, in this case, first one is non-negativity, f of x greater than or equal to 0. And second one is sum of the probabilities, we are taking interval is minus infinity to infinity. F of x is dx equal to 1 or f of t dt equal to 1. These two are two properties for the random variable x and its density function. Okay, now. And properties of cumulative distribution function, capital F of x. Okay, let x be a random variable with cumulative distribution function indicating the capital F of x. Then cumulative distribution function satisfies the following three properties. First one is capital F of minus infinity equal to 0, capital F of infinity equal to 1, and capital F of x is an increasing function. Increasing function means if x is less than y, which implies f of x less than f of y. If x is less than y, which implies capital F of x less than capital F of y. These three are properties of cumulative distribution function. Okay, now? Next, relation between cumulative distribution function and probability density functions. If x is a range space Rx of random variable x, is given by range space Rx equal to x1, x2, x3, and so on, xn. So these are increasing values. We have some order. X1 less than x2 less than x3 and so on less than xn, n number of points. Then density values, probability value f of x1 which is equal to capital F of x1, f of x2 equal to capital F of x2 minus capital F of x1, f of x3 equal to capital F of x3 minus capital F of x2, order values. Okay, so this is the relation between density function and cumulative distribution functions. Okay, now we have some graph. Okay, x1, x2, x3, x4, and so on. So starting point x1 value, you have some function is on the x-axis. Next, x1 function value is here. X1 to x2 value f of x1 is. Next, x2 to x3 is the function. Next, x3 to x4 is the function. X4 to remain value f of x4. Okay, is f1, next f2, f3, f4. Okay, these are the cumulative distributed values. We are adding these two sums. These two sum is here, these two sum is here, these two sum is here, these three sum is here. Okay, so this is the relation between cumulative distribution function and density functions. Next, I am giving the one example how to determine, if given the density function, how to determine distribution function. If distribution function, cumulative distribution function is given, how to determine density function. Find the probability density function of the random variable x. In this problem giving cumulative distribution function, and we have to determine probability density function. Here giving CFD, you should determine the PDF, density function. Okay, the CFD distribution function is given. F of x, capital F of x equal to 0, 0.25, 0.5, 0.75, 1. Okay, sum of the total values is exactly equal to the last one is 1. Okay, x value, if x is less than minus 1, that value is 0. If x minus 1 to 1, that value is 0.25. 1 to 3, 0.5. 3 to 5, 0.75. x greater than 5, that value is 1. Okay, find the density function. And also find the p of x less than or equal to 3 and p of x equal to 3 and p of x less than 3. Less than or equal to 3 means that range space Rx value having, we should determine first of all, identify the range space of the random variable x. That range space random variable is a discrete value. The discrete values are minus 1, next -1 to 2, 1 means -1, 1, 3, 5. Okay, -1, 1, 3, 5. These four values are range space values, elements of range space. Okay, so that's why I'm giving the range space values here. I'm solving that problem. Range of the random variable x is indicating the rx, that rx is given by -1, 1, 3, 5. Okay, so endpoints of the interval of the given distribution function. Okay, probability density function of x is given by on rx is f of x equal to density function. Okay, f of minus one equal to, we have some form we are using last one, how to determine density function by using the cumulative distribution function. So that is f of x1 equal to capital F of x1. Next, that is first one, capital F of x1 equal to small f of x1. So f of x2 equal to capital F of x2 minus capital F of x1. Here x2 equal to 1 and x1 equal to minus 1. Here x1, x2, x3, x4. Okay, so f1 value 0.5, f of minus 1 value 0.25, that value is 0.25. similarly, f of 3 equal to capital F of 3 minus capital F of 1, that is capital F of x3 minus capital F of x2. X3 value 3, x2 value 1, that one density, so the distributed values are just I'm subtracting, we will get the 0.25. similarly last one also. Okay, so these four values are density function values, probabilities. Okay, and also determine p of x less than or equal to 3. P of x less than or equal to 3 means -1, 1, 3. Okay, so add the probabilities at -1 and at x equal to 1 and at x equal to 3. So add these three values, sum of these three values is p of x equal to -1, p of x equal to 1, p of x equal to 3. So also we call f of -1, f of 1, f of 3. Simply we call capital F of 3, which value is exactly equal to capital F of 3, because cumulative values. Okay, that three values are we already determined. So we add these three values. Okay, above three values, first one, second one, and here first one, last one. So finally we got 0.75. and also determine p of x equal to, p of x equal to small f of 3. Small f of 3 is capital F of 3 minus capital F of previous one value, and capital F of x3 minus capital F of x2. 0.75 minus 0.5, we get the 0.25 value. And also should determine last one, p of x less than 3. P of x less than 3 means we can't add 3. Less than 3, less than 3 values are x equal to -1 and x equal to 1. Should add the two values only. So simply we call that is capital F of 1. Okay, less than 3 values 1. Okay, that value is capital F of 1. That we add the two values, you will get the 0.5. So this is the procedure to determine, if giving cumulative distribution function, determine the density function. If giving the density function, determine the cumulative distribution function. We already explained in the previous lecture, and I'm explaining the second example. If the real valued function f from R to R defined by f of x equal to 2 into x to the power of minus 2, if interval is -1 less than x less than 1 to 2, otherwise 0, is the real valued function, is the real valued function is probability density function for some random variable or not. So just check the, is it valid density function for random variable or not. If it is a density function of any random variable, it must and should satisfy the two properties. The two properties are already we discussed in the previous lecture, in the starting of this lecture. That is non-negativity condition and sum of the total probability is exactly equal to the 1. So here we have to show that f is non-negative and area under f of x, area under the curve f of x is unity. That is, so total sum of the probability. So indirectly we are using area. Area is total value, sum of the. Okay, since domain of f is, the interval is 0 to 1, it is clear that f is non-negative on 0 to 1 because of, so function f is f of x equal to 2 into x to the power of minus 2 in interval 0 to 1. X power minus 2 means 1 by x square, x power 2, 1 by x square. So whatever it numerator or denominator, 1 by x square. X square is whatever it value, x value either negative or positive, other than 0, that value always greater than 0. Greater than 0. 2 by greater than 0. Total value also greater than 0. F of x always non-negative. Okay? Non-negative value. Since f is the, so it is clear that f is non-negative on interval 0 to 1. Next, we should show the sum of the properties exactly equal to 1. Now show integral minus infinity to infinity f of x equal to 1. Why you are using in minus infinity integral value? Because of x is continuous interval. We are giving function, continuous function on the interval, which is not a discrete value. So that's why we are using the integral minus infinity to infinity f of x dx, f of x dx. So calculate that integral value minus infinity to infinity f of x dx equal to, so function f of x value is minus 1 to 2, value 2 into e x to the power of minus 2, other than 0. Remaining value is 0. Just integrate this value, you will get the 2 into x power minus 2 integration is minus 1 by x. Limits are 1 to 2. The total value is 1, which is exactly equal to the 1. Hence proved. So first one is non-negativity is also existed, proved, and next sum of the probabilities is exactly equal to 1. So therefore, so given function f is a valid probability density function of some random variable x, which is a valid density function. And you should check the in personally yourself. So example, to check f of x equal to 1 plus mod x if interval is minus 1 to 1. Okay, is the function valid density function or not? Okay, f of x in the interval minus 1 to 1. Mod x is always greater than or equal to 0. Okay, mod x is always greater than or equal to 0. 1 is greater than value. 1 plus mod x is also greater than or equal to 0. That means first property is existed. First property is holds. So that is non-negativity is holds. But you should check the second one. That second property is, so first property is f of x. F of x equal to 1 plus x. If x value is greater than 0, greater than 0 means 0 less than x less than 1. Next, 1 minus x. Okay, that is minus 1 less than x less than or equal to 0 or less than 0, whatever it is. 0 otherwise. Just I'm classifying the dividing this function mod x value. Mod x value is sometimes greater than 0, sometimes less than 0. Minus x and plus x. If x is greater than 0, that is plus x. If x is less than 0, that is minus x. Okay. Which value is always greater than 0? And the first property is holds. That first property is non-negativity. Hold. Next, you should check the second one. That second property is integral minus 1 to 1 f of x dx, which is equal to integral minus 1 to 0 f of x dx plus integral 0 to 1 f of x dx, which is equal to integral minus 1 to 1, sorry, 1 to 0. That value is function values. We are classified two types, two ways. First one is 1 minus x into dx. Next, second one is 0 to 1 is 1 plus x dx. Integrate first one. That integration is, one integration is x. X integration x square by 2, limits are minus 1 to 0, sorry. Next, x plus x square by 2, limits are 0 to 1. So what value is substitute upper limit and next lower limit? That upper limit is 0 minus 0. Next, minus of lower limit is minus 1, minus 1, minus of minus 1 whole square by 2 plus upper limit is 1, 1 plus 1 by 2, 1 square by 2. Lower limit is 0, so the value is also 0. Finally, minus of first value is 0, next minus of minus 1, minus 1, minus 3 by 2. Next, second one is also 3 by 2. So, what value minus 1 minus plus 3 by 2 plus 3 by 2 value is 3, which is not equal to 1. 3 is not equal to 1. So, therefore, given f of x is not a valid density function. So this is the procedure to determine given function is the valid density function or not. Okay, you should check the yourself. So use some problems in internet or whatever in available sources. Okay, so thank you.